Hey folks, welcome to the Wild West Crypto Show Daily Update, brought to you by Carnomaly. Thank God it's Friday. Hey, now remember folks, starting Monday, the Daily Update will be at 3:30, coincides with the closing of the market, so that way the numbers aren't bouncing around on Brent. Really? Speaking of numbers bouncing around.
Well, Ben, I tell you what, we got the bouncy ball on the crypto side of it. Bitcoin's up about 800 points right now. That puts us at 18,610. You look at the chart on that, like I told you, man, it is rocking and rolling. If you look at that, let's see if I can spread this baby out here. You look at that thing, it's just straight up, up and away. So you can see it's broken through that trend channel. Nice move. It won't go to the moon forever. At some point, some people will take some profits. And because it's kind of a thin market, you got to kind of wonder if when those profits get taken, exactly what effect they're going to have on everything. Total market is up 4.65. Bitcoin's up 4.45, so the altcoins are running a good amount today. You know, the divergence that we've been talking about is starting to take a little bit of hold, possibly, because we got the Dow down 219. And again, you can kind of look at that chart, and as you can see, and I've been telling you, that gap that we've got there on the far right is probably going to get filled with a red candle, is my guess. And so the Dow is down 219, that's at 29,263. And you look at the S&P, it's down 0.68%, Dow down 0.75%, NASDAQ down 0.60% right now. Gold's up 730, that puts it at 1872. Again, notice that it's just kind of sliding down, but I'll tell you what, if you can consolidate with a slight downward bent, that's not bad at all, considering the move that had up. Silver, it's up 16 cents at 24.18. Same kind of chart pattern as you got with gold. And of course, then we look at oil. Oil's standing strong, 42.40. You know, I know that we're going to get rid of all fossil fuels here in the next couple months, but at least until then, it's at $42.40 for a barrel of West Intermediate crude. And then let's go out to our December 21, 19,490, up 420, 19,490, and it's at 18,600. So guess what? It's only about 800 points.
Yeah.
So the futures are telling you they're not buying this run away, the current one. They're looking in December of next year for it to be up. But everybody's got to start looking a little bit, wondering how much farther all this is going to go. So all in all, not a bad day for the markets on a Friday.
Yeah, on a Friday.
We'll see what Monday brings.
Yeah, exactly. So a little bit of news stuff going on. I thought this one was kind of interesting. It kind of reminds me of the Dominion vote machine folks. They were supposed to show up for a hearing today and they just no-showed, which is kind of like the Meta One crypto psychic fraudsters. They won't show up in court. They were supposed to go to, so apparently this trio of fraudsters bilked investors out of about $9 million. They kind of had their own church, and so they're using their religious exemption to say, we don't have, you know, badges. We don't have to show, you know, badges.
Stinking badges, you know. Hey, you know, that church exemption, that's one I hadn't thought of. That's kind of creative. You know?
It is, man.
Those guys ought to get an advertising instead.
that's a scammer 101, man. But, you know, talking about Bitcoin and all that, I thought this was interesting, okay? So, you know, PayPal just recently made it through Pantera Capital that you could buy cryptocurrencies through PayPal.
Yeah.
And folks, I have to tell you, what they've seen is a huge uptick. Matter of fact, they even say that the demand has been so high since they started doing that there's more Bitcoin being bought through PayPal than is even being mined, okay?
Whoa.
So that means that there's stores of Bitcoin, probably ties a little bit to this run. What most of you folks out there don't know is that you can go to the exchanges and buy it and save yourself probably 2 to 5% because PayPal is getting their cut.
Yeah. You know? But you know what? Whatever gets them in the game.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, we're happy to see it.
The reality is, I mean, you know, look at retail.
Yeah.
There's the ultra retail, sit down, we're going to drink a tea with our pinky finger out and have a crumpet or some little piece of nothing that just pisses me off and that's not even enough to
feed. It's not food.
You know, it's not food. And there's those that do that, and they buy the same thing that you know, just a scaled down version at Walmart.
Absolutely. I have to tell you, forget the guy's
name. All you got to do there is, you know, elbow the fat person next to you so you can get it.
No, that's Antifa and BLM doing that. Okay. Yeah. But, you know, the guy who started convenience stores was out of Dallas. Can't remember his name, but he started, you know, with a stop-and-go 7-Eleven and all that. And the reason it was convenience stores, you go to the grocery store and buy a six-pack of Coke at the time for $1, but you go to the convenience store and paid 50 cents for one Coke.
Yeah.
And it was the convenience of going into there, how they kind of got their name. So, yeah, folks, if it gets you in the game, you don't know anything about it, you feel secure with it, get in there. And for those of y'all that started doing this a month ago, you made money.
Well, and they haven't worried about the 2 to 5% because they bought it here at 10 or 12 and it's already at 18 and they forgot all about what PayPal took out of it.
That's right. According to November, it was over 361 million active users.
There you go.
So bada bing. And then we're going to close this out with a little bit of good news. And this is campaign related, but it's good news.
Okay.
I thought this was hilarious. An outfit out of Florida, all the campaign signs that are everywhere.
Oh, yeah.
That's used with what they call Coroplast. And if you look at that stuff on the end, it's got holes in it. They said donate that to a beekeeper, because what they do is they'll cut it, stack and glue them all together, and you have pre-made beehives. So, and they said the bees don't care if you're Republican, Democrat.
They don't give a rat's tail.
They said that when they
stick that honey in there, no matter what you are.
That's right. So that's the best way to sweeten up politicians. Folks, have a great weekend.
That's probably the only way to sweeten up politicians.
We'll see you back here Monday, 3:30, folks.